What's good, it's your boy Montana 300, man. Rap God, FG shit, man. Shout out to World Class Lifestyle. You already know what it is, man. Squad.
Yeah, you know I've been here in hoes like I'm Emmett. She let me cut cause I'm shopping my image. I'm ballin' for real, what the fuck is a scrimmage? She wanna feel it. She wanna pay me a visit. She want me behind her, no Civic. Woo, damn.
What up, y'all? Welcome back to World Class Lifestyle. Today we are reacting to Pop Smoke, Tunnel Vision, no official audio. Let's get straight to it. That shit was fucked up. Alright. Team me up, Pop. Skull.
Mommy like, damn boy, you made it.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
But she said, you ain't nice.
At all.
I'm telling you, no, I'm look, nice. I don't talk to niggas. I don't feel these niggas at all. Got 100 round in my pocket, I'm ready to go kill these niggas. And it's tunnel vision. When I'm in the field, nigga. If I tell Mikey Woo that he gon' go drill a nigga, I'm a Brooklyn nigga. But shout out my Philly niggas. I don't fuck like with a lot of niggas because I'm too real for niggas. They know what it means.
I like that. That's real. He said, I'm a Brooklyn nigga, but shout out my Philly niggas. And he said, I don't fuck with too many. Wait, real quick. I want to say something. Whenever it comes down to, like, because this is the last track up on the album and shit. Whenever it comes down to, like, the last tracks on albums, they usually be, like, a little dry. This shit ain't dry. I can tell, like, the first 29 seconds of it, it's not dry. Like, you know, when I, like, it. In the past, when I've heard full albums, the last track be kind of dry. Like, damn, ain't the last track supposed to be, like, the most, like, the one that you want people to remember type shit, because it's the last track. It's usually the first one that be that they had for people to remember, but then the last one be kind of like, damn, you just say, all right, fuck it, throw that one last type shit, you feel me? But shit, who knows what artist, but this shit ain't dry. By far, it's not dry. That motherfucking beat came in, talking this shit, I like
it. I don't fuck with a lot of niggas because I'm too real for niggas. They know what it means to have $1 million dreams. Then you wake up on the block and it's back to serving fiends. I don't drink Belair, but I'm a Belair like I'm Uncle Phil. Don't call me bluff, nigga.
Hold on, but he said,
yeah, I don't drink Belair, but I'm a Belair like I'm Uncle Phil.
Okay. He said, I don't drink Belair, but I'm a Belair like Uncle Phil. You know, Uncle Phil off of the Fresh Prince of Belair. Rest in peace to Uncle Phil. You know, he passed away in real life and shit. But rest in peace to him.
And it's back to Sharper Fiend. I don't drink Belair, but I'm a Belair like I'm Uncle Phil. Don't call me bluff, nigga. I am and nigga, I will. Yeah, I'm from the field. Now it's $1 million deals. And it's going out of nowhere. Push me and I'ma go here. All in a second.
Hey, push me and I'ma go there. You don't go there with your dumb ass. Don't do that.
Dollar deals. And it's all out of nowhere. Push me and I'ma go there. All in a second. Gun kicking like it's Tekken. I'm a force to be wrecking.
Okay, hey, talk your shit. He said gun kicking like it's Tekken. I'm a force to be wrecking. Come on, bro.
All in a second. Gun kicking like it's Tekken. I'm a force to be wrecking.
Well, I get the bar. Tekken is the little fighting game. I used to play that shit. Don't sleep. Don't be like, oh, you missed it. Nah, bro. I used to play Tekken. It was the little fighting game, and they'd be kicking a lot up on there. The little, it'd be like, I'm not trying to be racist, but it'd be like the Asians and the Chinese people and shit like that. They'd be going, it was all different types of races, but, you know, I mainly remember, like, the Asians and shit like that. But, yeah.
All in a second. Gun kicking like it's Tekken. I'm a force to be wrecking. I'm God's perfection. Look, God gave me a lot of some months, but it could go in a second. If I fucked the wrong bitch or woke up in the wrong session. I don't talk to niggas. I don't feel these niggas
at all.
Got 100 round in my pocket, I'm ready to go kill these niggas. Look, and it's tunnel vision. When I'm in the field, nigga. If I tell Mikey Woo that he gon' go drill a nigga, I'm a Brooklyn nigga. But shout out my Philly niggas. I don't fuck with a lot of niggas because I'm too real for.
I guess God wanted me to pause it there. I don't know why my shit just paused, but I like this. I don't know why my shit just paused right there, but I guess God's saying it, or maybe Pop paused it for me. No? Okay. Shit. Is my shit gonna play though? Like, what's going on?
Niggas, they know what it means to have $1 million dreams. Then you wake up on the block and expect to suffer fiends.
Changed the game. Pop Smoke came in and showed them niggas a new vibe. The whole sound, the whole vibe, the whole movement.
Facts.
Different.
Forever my heart, forever my dogs. Still gonna pull up for you. Smoke will never clear. Never.
Never. Never. Never.
Wow.
Smoke will never clear. I like that. I like that. That shit cold. But hey, like I was saying, bro, I have never heard, like, I've been saying this shit from the start, like, way before I even reacted to the album, this Pop Smoke album. I've been saying, like, bro, this nigga voice different, like his sound, like it's way different than others. You know, I never heard, like, only like deep voice nigga that I ever heard rap was DMX, and that's he top 10 all the time. DMX is top 10 all the time on my all time list and shit like that. And Pop Smoke came in just like I always said, he had a whole different voice, like, and he could sing with that shit too. Like, that's one thing that I learned from this album. Damn, excuse me, I burped again. But that's one thing that I learned from this album is that he can really sing, bro. Like, I didn't know that. Like, when I heard him up on the song with, well, check out that reaction, For the Night with DaBaby and Lil Baby, I was listening. I'm like, is that really Pop Smoke singing? And then I'm listening. I was like, that really is him. And y'all was telling me, yeah, that's Pop. I was like, whoa, I did not know he could sing like that. But damn, I'm bullshit. But, yeah, that's one goal that he did achieve. The lady, ooh, shit, that's all outside of the screen and shit like that. I'm fucking up. But that is one goal that he did achieve, you know? The lady asking him, like, hey, where do you see yourself? What do you want your impact to be 50 years, 100 years later and shit like that on the music industry and shit? And then he just said, hey, I want them to know that I had a different sound. You know, I brought a different sound. He changed the wave of music and shit like that. He most definitely did. He brought a whole different sound. Like I always said, nobody voices like that, niggas. But yeah, man, rest in peace, Pop Smoke. Y'all, as y'all can see, well, shit, hold on. If y'all enjoyed this video, please make sure I hit that like button. Comment down below what y'all rate this song. Got a 10, this shit is a dime piece, 10 out of 10. Like I said, some artists usually slack off with their last track on their album and shit. This nigga Pop Smoke didn't. He brought that same pressure, and I like it on me. But as y'all can see, the next reaction is Shoot for the Stars, Aim for the Moon album ranking. I'm going to be ranking the album from, like, you know, I think it was like 18, 19 tracks or some shit like that. So it's going to be like 1 through 18. My favorite track going to be number 1. My least favorite, not even my least favorite. I don't even know how to say that because I don't want to say the best words because all of the songs is good up on the album. And I don't want to say my least, but fuck it. The song I wouldn't bump as much would be at the bottom, you know, the lowest one. And then the song I bumped the most would be at the top. And the song that I felt was the best song overall in the overall project. But yeah, that's gonna be the next reaction and shit like that. Give me a couple days because I got to actually put time in to making a list and everything. And then I got y'all on me. Shit, share all of my videos and don't be stingy. And please make sure I hit that subscribe button and press the bell so that y'all get notified every single time I drop a video. Thanks for watching.
See me on TV and on the internet.